with my bottom three, it of course would be you two. And with my decision making, I decided to bring...
Wait, three?
Yes, three.
We're gonna bring somebody back.
Eliminating somebody that I kind of didn't give another chance to, I decided to bring them back.
This is somebody that I think deserved another chance. Let's see if we can still earn his spot.
I'm back, bitches.
You gotta be kidding me.
I'll tell you what's gonna win.
Hey. Finally down to my top three. I think fair surprise to bring back John because, I think he deserved another chance. He didn't have enough time to open up to me, and bringing him back was a good decision.
All right, if that's the case, I'm just gonna do my confessionals with my shirt off because I need it.
Like I said, Jordan is that one person that I have been like on a steady, consecutive, like relatable relationship with. King is that man's man. He's a gentleman, he's polite, he's handsome, his melanin is perfect.
All these motherfucking light skins.
And I just know he has this big ass dick, so it's just honestly like, you know, the full package. So it's gonna be really, really hard to boil it down to these last three. Set up an appointment and we'll just go ahead and do that, and we can set up something. Yeah, you okay? All right.
So it's a brand new day, my friends are gone, and I feel so devastated.
All right, so I have my final three, the final three that are meant to be, I guess. We'll see. I'm glad you guys made it this far. Jordan, how do you feel about being in the top three?
Well, I mean, I was confident enough. I knew I was gonna be here for a long run. Cause you know, I'm here for you. I care for you. And, you know, I think you know that.
I definitely see that. John, welcome back. I'm glad that you made it back. I'm glad that you decided to come back.
It feels great to be back.
And I apologize for making the decision for leaving you earlier.
Accepted. You know what you was missing? And I don't think I got a fair chance, so.
All right. Tell me your point.
I'm pretty sure one of these bitches got in his ear, and now he's back to his senses, so I'm back.
My king is still running the jungle.
Hey.
How do you feel right now?
I'm feeling good. I definitely predicted this. The Melanin King is here.
I actually predicted this myself, so I'm glad we're on the same page. So before we go ahead and just start this elimination process, there's one more surprise I have for you guys. I can't make the decision by myself, so I decided to include somebody that's been very, very influential and important in my life.
Who is he gonna bring? Is it his mom, his sister?
This person has kind of guided me through my lifestyle and also been, you know, my right-hand man for a long time.
His pastor, like his dad, I don't even know what to think.
And do not judge this person by the color of their skin. This is my Uncle Pete.
Hey!
Uncle Pete!
Hey, hey. Uncle Pete! Okay, so. Now I gotta be cool with the uncle.
Uncle Pete is here for you guys. I'm gonna have Uncle Pete sit down with you guys and talk to you guys for a little bit so he can get a kind of feel of what's going on and how he feels about you guys.
Most of the time, this is the type of guy I go for. You know, white, chubby, sugar daddy-ish looking. I'm so excited to meet him.
He's gonna let me know who is the best mate for me.
I don't really know what's gonna happen through Uncle Pete. I really just wanna get to Nick. Again, it's whatever.
All right, have fun, Uncle Pete.
And if they don't get Uncle Pete's approval, they don't get my approval. It's that simple.
Hey man, what's up? I'm Uncle Pete. How you doing?
Nice to meet you.
So what's going on, man? You enjoying this whole thing, this whole process?
I'm enjoying it. I'm just being a gentleman. It's like, I'm in a house filled with, you know, all those bottoms and all that. And there's just attention and they arguing and all that, but I'm from the Bronx.
Oh, I like the Bronx. There's a lot of action happening
where
up there.
Where are you from?
He's like my best friend. He's like a father figure. He's my trap dad. Like, you know, I get all the best drugs from him. Every time I go out of town or even out of the country, Uncle Pete is there. You know?
Hey, Uncle Pete.
Hey, how are you?
I'm good.
Good. I like your style, man. Oh, you got it all figured out. I like that.
Uncle Pete reminds me of, personality-wise, Mrs. Doubtfire. You ever seen that movie? Yeah. Personality-wise, that's what he reminds me of.
I hear a little accent going in and out. What's going on?
Oh, yeah. I'm Jamaican, so it's just
like, oh, that, nah, it's a strong, you hit that Jamaican word.
I'm Jamaican, and, you know, like, every single person them really, really likes a Jamaican, you know, just
So tell me, I hear you're a shy guy.
I am at first, but once I get to know you, then I kind of loosen up. Yeah, you can't just be like out there like the first time like that.
But that's kind of hard in this competition, isn't it?
Well, yeah, it is.
The Jamaicans are the best lovers.
The best.
Yes. Best. And lovers. The biggest dicks.
And the biggest dicks.
Right.
Nothing under 12. Nothing under 12. If flirting back with Uncle Pete is the way to get to that, I mean, I don't mind.
That's wonderful for you.
Definitely.
There's got to be something that Nick brought you back for. What do you think it is?
Yeah, I feel like he saw the potential in me.
Let me ask you something. How do you compete against a 12-inch Jamaican cock?
I'm so sorry.
Yeah, well, what can you do?
Kind of handsome.
Oh, thank you. You're a pretty good looking guy yourself.
Thank you.
I like all the tattoos.
You know, when Uncle Pete puts his hand on my thigh, I'm like, ooh, don't do that because I want to do some things to you.
Well, what do we got here? What's that?
A little Polynesian tattoo.
Oh, did they hit you with a single now?
Yes.
Woo! On your hand and everything like that?
I like pain.
Oh.
Like, I'm just so drawn to his eyes. Like, he's so freaking hot. I just, like, want to go over there, sit on his lap, and just, like, suck his dick in front of production.
Oh, well, we can definitely talk about that.
Yeah, I guess.
I got to contain myself. Like, Nick is here. Like, I don't want him to be like, you know, what's going on? So I got to play this very, very, very low-key.
I've always been able to control my balls, so that's never been an issue before.
Ooh, you're a feisty young man, aren't you?
Yes, I am.
Hmm.
And it now narrows down to my bottom three. This has been so long and so hard to do this process, but it took a lot of thought, a lot of consideration, and my Uncle Pete also did help me with this deliberation as well. So let's just get to it.
I know that I'm perfect for him, so I'm just very, like, nervous about tonight's elimination.
I want to thank everybody for coming and joining me in this adventure. But the person I choose to be my partner, so I'm no longer the eligible bachelor, is John.
Yes! I knew it!
And I honestly think that it deserves to go to John.
He chose John, and he chose wrong. Good for him.
It's all good, Nick. I know how to move on.
I'm so glad I brought you back.
Wait. I can't accept this. I'm actually married, and I've been messing around with the bartender.
With the bartender? Are you serious right now?
Well, after two kids.
This is a joke. This has to be a joke.
I slept with the bartender because I love to drink, and a bitch wanted free liquor.
Okay,
that was kind of fucked up.
Now that John didn't accept, we are going to go with my second choice, which was also a very, very good one.
And this was honestly my gut feeling who I kind of wanted to choose first.
My eligible bachelor will be Jordan.
You know, we just really connected, and I think that we can definitely see a relationship growing.
I can't accept. Me and Uncle Pete been fucking for the last 30 minutes and we're in love.
Are you fucking kidding me right now?
In the short amount of time that I've been with Uncle Pete, he has shown me that he's more of a man than Nick will ever be.
Uncle Pete, you're just... This can't be happening. This isn't real. This is a joke?
I'm gonna run off with Uncle Pete and we're gonna go sit on a yacht, travel the world, sip on some champagne, live a good life.
My king, bae. What's up?
So, a fake shipping wine over here.
And it's for me.
I kissed your foot when no one was looking. I ate your ass when no one was looking. So, you're gonna stay there. Look at this Jamaican melanin while I say fuck you a bit.
Fucking kidding me right now. This
kid. I'm not about to be anyone's last option. I'm not doing that.
Do you want to think about it or no?
Yeah, I'm never a last option. I'm always the option.
I'm gonna go and find someone else.
That was a waste of time. Do I get a do-over or something?
Sir, can you please make sure they have my check and everything ready? Cause I'm. This is the kind of shit I'm talking about. Yeah, this, exactly.
This was definitely a waste of time.
Do I get a do-over or something?
You know what? Y'all think that motherfucking care, but guess what? I don't. Who need one of you niggas anyways? You know what I'm saying?
Anything?
We got me, myself, and this motherfucking dick. All right? We're gonna be just fine. Fuck you. You know what? Turn this shit off. Turn this off.
Cause I'm ready to go. Like, I have a yacht waiting for me. I have my man waiting for me. I have some money waiting for me. A shopping spree waiting for me. And I'm like so done with this. Like, this is bullshit.
Sure.
Yeah. Fuck everybody. Fuck you, Nick. You're dumb for not picking me. See you later.